smartphone, different artwork on it. I just helped out a fellow art model in the Zoom session, and I'm going to go live on Facebook. Live on Facebook now. I'm going to try to speak more slowly. When I've been doing these Facebook and YouTube videos, I have been talking really fast and being really hyper and nervous. I think that my nervous energy is my anxiety. I think I have a lot of fear right now because of the situation we're in, financially as well as medically, trying to be safe. Hi everybody who's joining me here on Facebook and hi YouTube. I'm recording a video for YouTube on my webcam that I'm going to upload after this and then live on Facebook. So pre-recorded YouTube and live. If you want to subscribe to my YouTube channel, it's kind of Kringen on YouTube. But okay, a fellow creative writing person asked me, she's a successful fiction writer. And she asked me a question. She said, what is your passion? Distill, why is it? Because nobody cares how you make your art. Well, some people might care how I make my art, but why do you make your art, and what is your art? So she said maybe people aren't interested. She has a philosophy about what really drives your art. And for me, the phrase, her phrase, she's a successful fiction writer, and she's self-published many books. And she's been writing full-time for 7 years, so she's a really smart, successful person. And she helps coach other people on manifesting their dreams with their career. And she wanted me to distill in just a few words what my main passion and goal is. And she said hers is to eradicate trauma. She was abused as a child. And so her phrase is eradicate trauma. Eradicate trauma. I thought, wow, that's pretty powerful. And I was thinking about personal power. And when she was saying, come from a place of power, and people tell me not to apologize for myself, come from a place of power. Behind me, can you see my kitty is lying down back there? Can you see? And then there's my guitar. So you can't see it on Facebook, but on YouTube, you can see artwork and my guitar in the background. Okay, so on Facebook, hello, you're seeing a different view. Go to my YouTube if you want to see the same video is on YouTube. This same video will be on YouTube after, and you can see a different camera angle. I have 847 subscribers on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much, everyone who's joined my YouTube. So, I was talking about my passion, and the phrase, my friend who is a fiction writer, says hers is eradicate trauma. Maybe mine is tame the shame, suck the sugar cane. So I'd say tame the shame. I was raised, I'm an only child of parents who divorced when I was 4, and I went back and forth between my parents, and I kind of felt as a little kid a little bit like my parents are sensitive and intelligent, and they put me in an alternative school, my mom did, and her idea. And so my parents did a lot of good things for me, and they encouraged me to be creative, so I'm very lucky in that way. But what caused me a lot of pain as a child, my trauma as a child, because everyone, every little kid goes through some kind of trauma, whether it's a death in a family, or an illness, or a mental problem, or a physical injury, or a psychological abuse, or physical or sexual abuse. I suffered from neglect. My parents neglected me on a certain emotional level from time to time. Like, they both did some really great things for me when they raised me. But the thing that wasn't good was they were both kind of invalidating and a bit critical. And they were both distracted by their love lives and their careers. They were, both my parents were trying to figure out their love life because they divorced when I was four because they did not belong together. And I felt kind of torn between the two of them back and forth. Like, I was one kind of Shannon with my mom and a different kind of Shannon with my dad. Maybe a third kind of Shannon with my grandma and my grandpa. So I think I felt ashamed of taking up space, and almost like an anorexic. I've heard anorexic people say that they feel like they don't deserve to take up space, and they develop an eating disorder maybe partly because they feel like they don't even deserve to be alive or take up space. And I relate to that idea of feeling ashamed of that, you know, like my parents maybe would have had a better life if I had never been born, and they would have finished college, because I think they both dropped out of college partly to get married and have me. And my dad needed to go to work to make money, and he dropped out of school. And my mom, it's a long story, but I feel like pain with shame might be one of my words. And so I just wanted to say, today I did something new. I helped a fellow figure model. There's another art model who works full-time in Seattle, which is a very good model. Her name is Shawna Holman. And thank you, Shawna, for teaching me about Zoom, on how to use Zoom, and I'm much better at Zoom now than I ever was before. I've only used it a few times, and I know now how to do the spotlight and mute people, and I know how to facilitate and be the co-host of a group on Zoom. And so I facilitated. She was the art model, and six people were drawing her for 2 hours, and she got paid to model for them, and I was the co-host facilitator person helping. And I was very polite and very nice during the whole thing. And then I was starting to feel a little bit, like, envious of the fact that she's the model. Hey, I'm a model, too, I was thinking. And she did say a few times, thank you, Shannon, for helping us. And so I'm really, really glad that I did that. But I admit that I started feeling a little bit, because I'm still trying to figure out how to get booked as an online art model. I've only done one session, but that was with a fan of mine who wanted a unique fashion show. And I did, like, an online Zoom, and he paid me for an online Zoom session that was an hour long. And it was really fun. And I got to model my different outfits, and my hand-painted shoes, and my socks that I wear with my sandals. And he had me talk about my artwork and kind of interviewed me about my art. So it wasn't really a regular traditional drawing and painting session. It was more of a creative performance, interview, fashion show kind of a thing. And I'm really grateful for that, and I get paid well for that. And so I'm still trying to figure out how to get booked as an art model, because the way it's done is I can make a calendar, and then I can invite people. See, I can invite people to book me randomly whenever they feel like it, and then they can donate to me a sliding scale fee, or I can charge a certain amount. Okay, there's two different things I wanted to talk about. One is, how do we do our passion and make a living online with it? Because this economic thing we're going through is, you know, economically, we really need to figure out how to make money online. That's me. I need to figure out how to make money online. So that's what I'm doing. And I want to follow my passion. And what my passion is with my artwork, because see, I've split in two different directions. This is similar to my childhood. When I was a little kid, I felt torn between my mom and my dad. And as an adult right now, I feel torn between wanting to try to make money with my art and trying to keep making money as a model. Because I got into art modeling to pay the bills, because models get paid by the hour. And artists don't always get paid by the hour, and artists don't always sell their work. They promote their work, but people may or may not buy it. Whereas when a model works, she's hired, he or she is hired and paid by the hour, guaranteed. So I got into modeling because it's an art-related creative job. I love like being nude in front of people. I feel comfortable and relaxed when I'm nude in front of people. For whatever reason, I don't know why, because I'm kind of shy in a way, but not shy. Shy but not shy. So I feel comfortable being nude in front of people. And so I got into modeling because it's an art-related job, but I always felt like my real passion was my actual artwork. If you go to my website, ShannonKringen.com, you can see the different artwork that I do, and you can subscribe, because thank you for subscribing to my YouTube channel. I have a Patreon, and I got a new member today. I've gotten a new member the last 2 or 3 days in a row, which is amazing. I have finer nude photos available on my Patreon for adults only, and they're just fine art nudes. They're not erotic, they're fine art nudes, and so they're not adult-oriented, even though they're nude, so it's adult only, 18 and over only. So you can join my Patreon, it's patreon.com/KRING, and that's one way in which I can earn a little bit of money, and I have memberships that are $1, $2, $5, and $10 a month, and I'm trying to add more content, and every week I'm going to add new content, photos, videos, I do a podcast and a radio show, I do two different radio shows. I do Hollow Earth Radio, Goddess Kring Radio, an hour every week, and then I archive it on Mixcloud every week, and then I do random anchor podcast called Life of Shannon Kringen, where I just do random. I did one today. So I do a lot of different things, and I feel torn in different directions. And then when I think about pain or shame, I've been accused of being a narcissist because I take a lot of photos of myself and because my art is a bit self-centered and I'm a model and all this. And I have been called an attention whore by people years ago, and it really bothered me. I was called a narcissist and attention whore by people who didn't like what I was doing. And this was many years ago, and it still bothers me. I still feel defensive, like I have to prove that I'm not a narcissist. And then I realized, maybe I am a little bit narcissistic. Like, it's a form of insecurity. Narcissism, some narcissists are very arrogant and they think they can do no wrong, like the current president of the United States seems to kind of think he never makes mistakes, he never apologizes, and he blames everybody else for anything bad, and then he takes credit for anything good. And that's a certain kind of narcissist. That's not the kind that I am. If I'm a little bit of a narcissist, in my opinion, it's a defense mechanism. If somebody is insecure, then they want to puff themselves up like a wild animal that puffs themselves up. And so I kind of feel like I'm trying to puff myself up. Maybe the whole Goddess Kring thing is kind of a way, like the Wizard of Oz. I know I've said this before, but like Shannon is maybe the little woman behind the curtain who's scared and a little bit shy. And then Goddess Kring is the Wizard of Oz. And maybe figure model, maybe art model Shannon Kring, the naked model, in front of everybody naked while they paint and draw me and immortalize me in my likeness. Even though it's their art, I'm honored to be the model for the other people that make art. Maybe that is a way of me making myself feel better. There's my kitty. Okay, on YouTube you can see my kitty in the background. On Facebook all you see is like some hot stuff back there. So if you go to YouTube, watch the video on YouTube, it's kind of a better camera angle, it's a wider angle lens on YouTube. You can see my artwork and my kitty in the background. So what I was going to say was maybe I'm puffing myself up. So personal power, I like to say tame the shame. So maybe I'm trying to tame the shame, and maybe if I'm a little bit of a narcissist. I also know I'm a very good, nice person, and I'm talented, and I'm sensitive, and so maybe I don't need to talk too much subconsciously about who I am, because then I really sound like a narcissist, right? So, I hope you're doing well. I hope you get something out of my videos. I don't just want to be a self-centered person that goes on and on about herself. I just feel like I need to explain a little bit. Maybe I'm a little defensive. I wish that I didn't have to be, but I helped another model today. So it just brought up issues for me. I felt a little bit competitive, a little bit jealous, and yet I was impressed. She did a really good job. Shawna Holman is a great art model here in Seattle, just like me. I'm Shannon Kringen, art model, and Shawna Holman is an art model, and she's been thinking modeling for about 5 years, and she's a really good model, and she is, you know, works really hard, and there's different ways. I'm still trying to figure out how to attract people that will hire me. I have been booked for a group on Tuesday night in Seattle, April April 21st from 6:45 p.m. to 9 p.m. I'm going to be Zoom art modeling live online for people who pay a fee, and then they join this one group that's in Seattle, that's broadcasting from Seattle. They used to meet in downtown Seattle in a place in Belltown, and they draw every other Tuesday or something from 6:45 to 9. So I'm going to do that. I booked my first session, and then another art school in Seattle booked me for two portrait sessions, and I'm waiting to find out about a figure session. And I'm not going to be nude on webcam. I'm going to have a bathing suit, a bikini, a one-piece, a two-piece bathing suit, or a bodysuit that's flesh-colored with dramatic light shining on me, so it'll be nice shadows. And so I'm going to do that. And then, so there's two ways, I think, to get booked as an art model online, because this is kind of a new thing. The two ways to do it are, for me, this is what Shawna Holman is doing, which I think is really smart, because she facilitated a group at the University of Washington every Sunday, and so she's continuing to do that. Every Sunday, she offers her services as a model on Zoom, and she might start hiring other models, so that she's not the model every single Sunday, she can rotate through other models. Hi, Shawna, how are you? I'm talking a little bit about you, and don't worry, I'm only saying positive things about your business as a model, and about how you're a good model, and about how I admire your work ethic, and how focused you are, and how I'm trying to figure out how to get myself booked as an online Zoom art model. And it seems like there's two different ways to do it. There's this sort of random, hey, everybody, I'm available, book me, you know, when you want, you know, and then I can list my hours, like, any, you know, any 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m., or, you know, I can pick random times and have people sign up on a calendar and book with me. Or I could say, hey, I'm Shannon Art Model, I'm Shannon Kringen Art Model, you know, every Wednesday at such and such a time, I will be here. Please drop in if you want. Maybe that's what I should do, if I could figure out a time. You see, there's people randomly booking me, and there's that option, but it's probably better to have a certain time. If I could just pick a time every week, or maybe three times a week, I could just be available and then just hang out in Zoom and see if anybody joins me and invite people. I'm still trying to figure out how to do that. Like I'm a talented person, but I'm a little disorganized, I have to say. And Shawna, if you're still here, I was really impressed with how, you know, you have a certain kind of calm way, like you're organized in a way that I think I could learn to be a little bit more organized. Everybody has their strengths and weaknesses, and I feel like I'm really creative, and I'm really reliable, and a good model, and a little bit disorganized. And although I worked at like 15 different places, and I wrote it all down and kept it all straight, so I guess I'm organized enough to do that. But there's just something calming about your style, Shawna. You have a certain like efficient, organized, you're good, like a real good manager. Like, I guess you have a master's degree, and I forgot what, but I mean, you have a master's degree, and you're trained in, you just have like a certain skill that I can learn from, that maybe I lack a little bit. And so I appreciate that about you. I hope that's not weird that I'm saying you have a lot of practice. Thank you so much. Yes, I agree. And sometimes I like lose patience with myself, and I panic a little bit, and so I need to kind of calm down, slow down, take a deep breath, and just keep learning as I go and don't give up. I get kind of discouraged sometimes and overwhelmed. So I need to kind of take a deep breath and take it one step at a time. I'm happy that I have a webcam and a smartphone. Right now I'm recording Facebook Live video here, and then I'm recording a video for my YouTube channel that will be the same video as this Facebook. So I'm doing two in one and putting it on Facebook. And I'm trying to encourage people, like I'm doing two things. I guess I'm trying to promote myself as a creative, artistic, multimedia artist and model, but I'm also hopefully trying to, I'm doing three things. I'm trying to make myself feel better, like everything's going to be okay, and we're going to figure out how to navigate this, all of us, in our own way. Like, we're going to take money online, or we're going to get our unemployment. We're going to figure out how to survive. Somehow we're going to do it. So I'm trying to make myself feel better. I'm hoping that I'll be encouraging to other people, or entertaining in some way, or maybe you'll get an idea because of something I say, or spark an idea in you, and then you'll do some new creative thing, which would be cool, and then you can share with me if you're doing some fun, cool thing, I'm always open to hearing about people's fun projects. So I'm promoting myself as an artist and a model, but I'm also just practicing my public speaking skills, I guess. I've had a lot of practice doing monologues into the camera, so I guess my whole God is Kring TV show is like, God is Kring, I'm doing a monologue. So maybe this is something I've been doing for over 20 years. But being an online Zoom model is totally new, and I have to learn how to do that. So one step at a time, I totally agree with that. So I'm going to just try to be nice to myself. Sometimes I feel competitive and envious of other people, and I'm ashamed of that. I feel ashamed of that. Although I know it's human nature to be a little bit competitive, like we are competitive as humans, but we are also collaborative and cooperative, and people help each other, and people trade, and sometimes I work with photographers as a model, and then I don't get paid, like we trade. I think I'm going to work with somebody sometime soon, whenever I feel safe enough to work with somebody, and we're going to trade images, and there's going to be no money involved, and so we're going to collaborate on fine art nude photos. And then I'm going to put those on my Patreon for people who enjoy fine art nudes. And then if I'm comfortable enough, or I could even do selfies because I have a tripod and a timer and body paint. And I want to do some unique fine art nude body paint photos of myself and put those on my Patreon. So that's one creative idea. So I'm just going to say that sometimes models get paid, and sometimes models trade with photographers for free, and that can be a good thing as long as the model and the photographer both sign a release and they share the images and they both feel like it's fair. I feel like if a photographer does really high quality images of me and gives me permission to use them to promote myself and to promote him or her as a photographer, then I feel like that's a fair deal. I've done other photo shoots where I get paid and I sign a release and I let the photographer have the images, and then so I don't know why I was saying that, but there's different ways, there's collaboration. So part of me feels, part of me is very shy, and part of me is sharing it to the camera. So I don't know, I just wanted to say, okay, so if you're still here, Shawna, thank you for having me help you today, Shawna, with your drawing session, and you did a really good job, and I hope that I wasn't inappropriate towards the end when I just felt a little tinge of jealousy, but you did a really good job, and the people, everyone drawing you was really nice, and they held up their drawings, and they did some really beautiful drawings of Shawna for Hype YouTube. There were some nice drawings done of Shawna Holman. You can look her up, S-H-A-W-N-A, H-O-L-M-A-N, Shawna Holman, art model in Seattle, and she has a website, and there's all kinds of cool photos and drawings, and she has her own sessions that she facilitates and books models for, and she models for her own session, and that's pretty cool. And I'm a model too, and I'm ShannonKringen.com, figure model. If you just Google art model, Shannon Kringen, you'll find me, or Goddess Kring, and you'll find me all over the internet. And I do a bunch of artwork. I made my necklace. This is a glass necklace that I made at my friend's art studio, and I paint and draw and do lots of different kinds of artwork, and mainly how I make a living is model. And now I'm thinking that this is my time maybe to try to figure out if I can make a little bit of money with my art. And I have patrons now on my Patreon, patreon.com/goddesskring, and I'm really happy and grateful and proud to say that I got a new few members the last week or two, and I think I'm up to 9 members or 8 members, or I make like $68 a month, which I'm thrilled with, and if I can keep their interest, I can expand on that. Of course, I have to pay taxes on that, but I'm happy to have an income from my art. And I share fine art nudes. If somebody pays $10 a month, then it's fine art nudes. And then I'm trying to add like a video section for posing on video. If somebody wants to draw or paint me from my Patreon, they can do that. I'm still trying to figure out how to do that in terms of what I want to offer people. But I am offering already fine art nudes on my Patreon. And so if you're an artist or a model, your Patreon and see if you can get people to sign up. And then I have like $1 a month and $2 and $5 a month levels. And I have my photography and my podcast recordings and my paintings, and so photos and paintings and poetry and audio recordings. So those are all multimedia art forms that I do that I share at least once or twice a week. I put new stuff on my Patreon at least once or twice a week. And then I've been adding to my YouTube channel almost every day lately, and my Facebook Live videos almost every day. Since I have so much time now, because I'm home all the time now, I guess I don't really miss riding all over the city. It's kind of nice to have a rest. It's nice to sleep in with my cat every morning. It's nice to have a rest from commuting north, south, east, west, all over the city. I'm just trying to figure out a structure for myself every day. So again, I'm going to try to see if I can get myself booked as a Zoom model randomly, or it's probably more organized and makes more sense if I pick a time and say, hey, people who like to draw me, how about every Wednesday at such and such a time, or how about every, you know, on the weekend, or, see, I can't figure out what time of day, and what, yeah, I don't know, I'll figure it out. So there's, you understand what I'm saying? Am I making any sense? I'm really tired. Am I making sense? So you're welcome, Shawna. I'm trying to learn to be more collaborative and cooperative and not focus on jealousy and competition, because that makes me feel sick in my stomach. When people are jealous and competitive, because it's true that every single person is unique and special. Every art model has their own gift. Every art model has their own body type and their own bone structure and different kinds of poses they can do. And every model is beautiful in their own way, and every artist is beautiful and does their own like style. And I'm happy that I'm both an artist and a model. And I hope you like the pictures I took of you today, Shawna, if you're still here with us. I took a couple photos with my smartphone of the webcam Zoom model session of Shawna's poses, and I think a couple of them turned out kind of cool. And to have an online webcam art model is a new thing. That's another idea, too. People can model in European countries. Like, we can, as art models, there's already probably a lot of other local models, but it's fun that we can mix and match our different modeling in different parts of the country or different parts of the world. I did email somebody in England, and I heard back from them, but I can't figure out how to register on their website. But apparently they're open to working with models, you know, in the United States. And so we could potentially, as art models, model in European countries, you know, on the webcam. And it would be fun for them because they've never seen us before because we're Americans. And vice versa, maybe some models from England and Ireland and Scotland and Norway or whatever could model in the United States, you know, on webcam. And so we could have, like, an international exchange of art models on the webcam. That'd be kind of fun. That's pretty cool. And yes, let's see, there reflected light on the wall. Oh, thank you so much. Yes, I think for painters especially, like, I noticed that I'm always, as a photographer, I'm always noticing, like, reflections of light on the wall, and I don't even know why it happened. Your clothing made this cool reflection on the white wall. And I don't even understand why that happened, because it seems like you were far away from that wall near the door, and yet it made kind of a pretty color and light reflecting on your clothing. So that's really cool. So I'm always noticing when I model things like that, or when I see somebody, or cool shadows, when there's cool shadows on the wall behind the model in the art studio. It's always fun to see that. So good, thank you. I'm glad that you appreciated that, and I thought it looked really cool, and I'm sure a painter would really like that. I'm sure that somebody could paint from, maybe you could set up that kind of pose again for painters with, you know, your colorful, whatever colorful outfit you want to wear, that will come up with, that will make a really cool reflection on the wall, and painters would love that. So, sunlight, super bright, yes. Yep. So I think natural light is good. Even though it washed you out a little bit, I kind of like the, like, well, I'm more of a photographer than a painter. Although, well, I paint, but I paint really abstract. I don't like to really paint from the model necessarily, but I appreciate models. I mean, I'm a model, you're a model. Models are beautiful, but I like to do pure abstract type art, like my necklace and like my tattoo. That's the design that I made up. But I like to do, like, Hundertwasser style shapes. Hundertwasser is an artist from Austria that I love, and he's pretty abstract. But really high quality. Like, there's a lot of really bad abstract art in the world, I have to say. Like, I don't like bad abstract art, but really high quality, well-composed abstract paintings and drawings, I love. like Summer Walker, like Rauschenberg, like Rothko, like Francis Bacon. I love Francis Bacon's work, and that Japanese lady, Yayoi Kusama, is that how you say her name? The Dot Lady, I love her. I love her work. I love her work. And Aboriginal paintings, I love that. So the art that I like personally is more abstract, but high quality, well-designed abstract art, and photography, and multimedia, and Laurie Anderson, things like that. So that's why I became a figure model, because I don't really want to draw or paint in a classical art style, but I love Renaissance art. It's beautiful. I love the naked human form. I think that men and women are beautiful, naked. I love the naked human form. So I became a model because I'm comfortable being nude, and because I love art, and because I don't really want to create realistic art. I want to be the realistic art model. So that's why I did that. And I also love it when kids draw me. When I wear a bodysuit or a leotard and little kids draw me, I love little kid drawings, little kid art, you know, with giant heads and, like, colors. You know, kids are not afraid to use lots of color usually, and they're more playful, and child drawings are so, like, I love the charmingness of kid drawings, and I just really love that. So, yes. So thank you for your comments, Shawna, and everyone else who's here. Maybe you're the only one here, Shawna. You're here with me, Shawna. maybe I should say goodnight, but I'm being a little sleepy, but I'm going to go for a walk sometime. Or should I dance around in my living room, and that could be my exercise for today. I like to walk at night when there's nobody else out there. And then there's a tree. I like to walk up at the top of the hill, and I stand next to my favorite tree, and I hug my tree. And then when I come home, I wash. I take all my clothes off, I throw it in the washing machine, and wash my whole body off, just in case anything, you know, God will make an outside that isn't good for me. And I'm going to eat more sauerkraut, you know, to keep the good bacteria in my gut, to try to help my immune system be the best it can be. And so I'm so grateful that I can help you today, Shawna, and I hope everything I did was good, and I would love to model for a Zoom group. I mean, like, start my own group. Maybe you could help me promote a group that, if I could pick a time, I think you said I should pick a time, and then if it works for me to pose for any of your Sunday groups, let me know if I could be one of the models who put it in through that. Good practice with nature. Yes, I really love, I love walking. I take my shoes off too. I go to this favorite tree at the top of the hill by my house, and I take my shoes off, and I stand barefoot in the grass, and I literally put my hands on the tree, and they say it's good. You know, people make fun of people that do that, but it feels good to me mentally, and I think physically it's doing something good to my body with the, like, electromagnetic, whatever, the earth and the ground. You ground yourself, and it feels good emotionally, and I think physically it's good to my body. I think it is. So I can't scientifically prove it, but some people are into their science with that, but it just feels good, and I think it's doing something. So in terms of booking a modern day gap, I'm going to try to figure out how to do this, and then also make money with my art and my Patreon. And somebody said if I try a little harder to promote my designs being printed onto things that I could sell, I'm going to try some of that. So I'm going to try a little bit of both. Most of my energy has been taken up by modeling for so many years, working with medical and art students, that I haven't had a lot of time and energy to do my actual artwork. So maybe I have, this could be an opportunity for me to do more of my multimedia art and actually try to make money with it a little bit. But it's true, I feel like it's totally fine for me to expect artists to pay me to model. But when I think about my artwork, I think, well, yes, but my art I should just give away for free, because that's what I'm used to doing. Because I did my public access TV show for 15 years and I wasn't allowed to make any money with it, it was non-profit public television, so we weren't even allowed to try to, you know, promote anything. So it had to be just public TV. Good to diversify. I fully agree with that. I also applied for, like, an online job where I can just type things. I forgot what it's called, annotation or something, and it sounds really boring, but I applied, and I'm good at sort of sitting there doing really tedious things. I'm really, like, excuse me, I'm meticulous about grammar and typing and all of that, and so I could do that, but I haven't heard back. But I might be able to just sit home and type things and make money online. That'd be cool. Waiting for modeling jobs to get, you know, happen. So there's different, yeah, diversify. So try different things. What else? And yeah, my Patreon is getting more members, and my YouTube channel, I can inspire people. My podcast, maybe there's some way. I thought about doing voiceover work. There's a website that I signed up with, and I made a voice sample recording of myself, but I can't seem to get the website to work right. But I have a friend, my friend's girlfriend is a voice actress, and her part-time gig is that she's a good actor, and she's trained in acting. I've done a little bit of acting, not a whole lot. Not really trained as an actor, but I have taken 5 or 6 classes in acting and improv and stuff like that. And people have said they like my voice. So I've done a podcast for 3 years, every week for an hour. So I do have experience doing that. And so my friend's friend might help me get into that, but apparently it's kind of hard to get into it. Unless you're into it, you know, then you can attract, if you're good and you're talented and you're hardworking, then in professionals you can attract more clients that want to hire you for your voice. But I think I'm better at just kind of improv talking than acting, but I don't know, that's my idea. So yeah, voice work, acting, but it's really fun to do monologues into the camera, and it's really fun to do podcasts and radio show. I love doing a radio show. Thank you so much. Let's talk more. Yes. Okay, thank you so much. I'll finish reading your comments after, Shawna. Thank you so much for your kind words. Thank you for being here with me. I really appreciate that, and I'm going to do my best. I don't know if I'm going to wear a bikini or a flesh-colored bodysuit. Maybe I'll have 2 choices for them. I'll say I can wear this flesh-colored bodysuit or I can wear this bikini. Whichever they think is best. I'll have a choice A and a choice B. And yes, I will respond and let's figure out the next step for me doing a Zoom modeling session and just keep the ball rolling on that and just keep trying to manifest modeling dates and figure out other ways to make a living. And this is for my mental health as well as my financial health. And yes, okay. Have a good night. Have a good night. I'm getting really tired. I just keep rambling, but yes, have a good night. Thank you for being here. I appreciate your presence here. I appreciate your work ethic and your high quality person. I appreciate that. You're smart and talented, so I appreciate that about you. Okay, I'm going to drink some of my smoothie. I always think I have to keep talking when I can't pause. So I'm going to make, this is a smoothie I made. I've been talking for 38 minutes. Wow, I've been talking for 38 minutes. So my name is Shannon Kringen, goddess Kring in Seattle. I should probably just do 10-minute videos, right? I don't know how much of attention span people have to listen to this long video of mine. Thank you for being here with me. Maybe I should have a rule that I should just do 10-minute videos. I don't know. Okay, so if you want to join my Patreon, it's patreon.com/goddesskring, and you can see fine art nude photos of me for $10 a month, and I'm going to add some videos of me posing. And if you want to pay $1, $2, or $5 a month, for as little as $1 a month, that's like 25 cents a week, you can have access to my artwork, to my photos. I take beautiful photos of animals and landscapes and the texture. People say I have a unique eye. I'm a good photographer. I take pictures of shadows and water droplets and textures and unique, unusual things that I see when I go for walks. I take pictures of myself that are really creative. I do face paint and body paint. I made this necklace, this glass necklace, and I do lots of different kinds of artwork, and I share it on my Patreon. So you can go on Patreon, and you can also just look at my website. You can listen to my radio show, Hollow Earth Radio, Mixcloud. Just Google that screen of Shannon Kringen if you want to find more out about me. I'll put some links down below of my art modeling website and my music. I have free music you can listen to on Bandcamp, plus free music and videos and artwork. So I will link below this. Hi Facebook and hi YouTube. I'm doing a YouTube and a Facebook at the same time. This is fun. Hi, YouTube. Hi, Facebook. YouTube. Facebook. YouTube. Facebook. Smartphone. Webcam. Smartphone. Webcam. So, this is Shannon Kringen Notice Kring. I'm going to call it a night. It's been 40 minutes. I've been on video for 40 minutes. So, it's time to say goodnight to everyone. So, have a wonderful day. I'm really grateful to be alive. I'm grateful I have a good immune system. I'm grateful I have a safe place to live. I'm really sorry for anybody who's in a bad situation. I feel a little guilty because I know a lot of people are worse off than me. But I know it's not helping them for me to feel guilty. So unless I can help somebody else, I need to go ahead and just be grateful for food and shelter and clothing and safety and security. And I'm really sorry to anybody that's suffering right now. I'm very, very sorry that there are people in the world suffering right now. I wish that I could save everyone, but I really can't. And so I'm not superwoman or underwoman or whatever. I'm only got a spring. Got a spring. So I have to say goodnight. And I love videotaping myself. It's really fun. This makes me feel more alive when I videotape myself. I want to tame the shame, I guess. Tame the shame and chuck the sugar cane. So I know you'll enjoy life and be passionate. So thank you for being here. I will link my websites below, and you can always watch if you're just joining us on Facebook and YouTube. You can replay this video as wanted. And I do a video almost every single day at this point on Facebook and YouTube. I've been doing daily videos. I do podcasts. I do an Anchor podcast and a Mixcloud podcast and a whole list of videos. So I do like about 3 different podcasts. I have 5 different blogs. Really OCD. Okay, so Shannon Kringen needs to say goodnight now. This is Goddess Kring, Shannon Kringen saying goodnight on Facebook and goodnight on YouTube. I'm going to close the YouTube first. Goodnight, YouTube. Thank you for subscribing. If you like my videos, please hit like and subscribe to my YouTube. I have a YouTube. It's Shannon Kringen on YouTube. Subscribe. Thank you so much for being here with me. Questions and comments, welcome. If you have anything that you want me to talk about or questions, I love to be interviewed. If anybody wants to interview me, I love being interviewed about artwork or music, or you can interview me about my multimedia art, you can interview me about my Goddess Kring TV show, you can interview me about my philosophy about life or nutrition or health or what I think, how to survive the crisis that we're in. This is both a medical and a financial crisis. Hope you guys are okay. Sending you love and peace and joy and health and strength. So do more of what you love as you possibly can. That helps your immune system. It calms down your nervous system if you're doing what you love. So do more of that. Thank you so much. Bye for now. Thanks for being here with me. Okay, I'm going to say goodbye. So I'm still on Facebook. I'm going to say goodbye to you. Bye, YouTube. Good night. Good night, John Boy. I'll see you later.